Holy Spirit, for the gifts of love, peace, and your mercies. We thank you, dear Lord, that through your Spirit, you have bound our hearts and our minds together to reflect on your word for our lives this day. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Almighty, who graciously have made this day possible for us to enjoy and celebrate in the mighty name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Beloved, indeed, to really find spiritual focus, it is important to sit under the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. Additionally, it helps to motivate you and I to keep our spirit aglow. Yes, many companies rely on inspirational conferences to rekindle enthusiasm. Enhance attitudes and restore focus to employees. Motivational speakers and company conferences have their place, but human advice only goes so far. To really find spiritual focus, sit at the feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. Nothing equals the motivation he gives for victorious living. And no one can equal his insight. Best of all, we don't have to shell out thousands of dollars to hear him. We can arrange a personal meeting every day. The psalmist in Psalm number 46, verse 10, especially the first part, declares, "Be still and know that I am God." This verse reveals our bottom line and our top priority The bottom line is he is a God, creator of the universe, sustainer of eternity. Our top priority is being still long enough each day to know him. We need dedicated periods of silence and solitude for prayer and the word. Our quiet time, with the emphasis on quiet, is for turning off the noise, unplugging the distractions, and meeting our Creator and our Maker. When our ancestors sat at home in earlier times, the only sound was the ticking of the clock on the wall. Working outside, they heard only the wind through the trees and the singing of the birds. When they walked by the creek, they listened to water gurgling over the rocks. But we can hear the birds for the traffic, or the ticking clock for the blatant television. We've replaced the gurgling water with whatever coming through our earphones. Friends, I'm not against our electronics. I'm just saying we need to turn them off long enough to be still a while. And we need to be still long enough to know that he is God. The Bible says, in quietness and confidence shall be your strength. Isaiah 30, verse 15. This is the attitude of prayer, and it should be a priority for us. My dear brother, my dear sister, learn to shut the door of your closet, as Matthew 6:6 enjoins us. Calm and quieted your soul, as Psalm 131 verse 2 advises us, and say, speak, Lord, for your servant hears. 1 Samuel 3:9. Have a blessed day, and may God richly bless you.
Sitting at the feet of Jesus, there I love to weep and pray. Yeah.
patience now.